Hello, everyone. Welcome to the workshop today. So today in this workshop, we're going to be doing a hands-on lab, essentially giving you the opportunity to play with Argo Rollouts and understand what it's about and actually interact with it and go through some of its core features in terms of what it provides. To start off this workshop, I've got a few slides just to explain what rollouts are for folks that may not be familiar with it. Should take maybe 5-10 minutes, and then a few slides on kind of the logistics of the workshop. And then finally, just a very brief overview of how it actually works. And then I'll turn you guys loose and you'll be able to log into the clusters that we have provisioned for this workshop and actually start working hands-on with rollouts. So that's the plan for this workshop. If at any point when you're doing the workshop you have a problem, feel free to raise your hand. More than happy to come by and help you. I'm joined today by Valentina, who will be assisting with solving problems, as well as Johnny. So any of us, if you have a problem, just let us know and we're happy to help you out. All right, so Argo Rollouts, what is it? It's really a drop-in replacement for the Kubernetes deployment object. If you've been working with Kubernetes and you're familiar with deployments, you know it's really got two strategies built into it. Neither of them are particularly sophisticated. One is recreate and the other is rolling. What Rollouts does is it really adds two more, not really adds, but replaces it with two advanced deployment strategies, which is Blue-Green and Canary. And we'll get each of these in a second. It can integrate with a variety of traffic routing tools like Trafic or Service Mesh like Istio, for example, in order to manage the weighting of traffic between, say, a Blue-Green or a Canary in a stable service. And it automates the deployment and rollbacks of things. So you think about how you do, say, for example, like Blue-Green or Canary in traditional infrastructure, even in a Kubernetes environment, you have to set up separate stacks. And then you got to write some automation that when you deploy the new version, you got to start shuffling traffic over, and then maybe write some testing and test scripts to make sure that what's actually rolling out is the new version works, right? And if it doesn't work, then automatically roll it back. That's what Rollouts does for you, is it provides all of that out of the box and makes this a lot more simple and easier for people to manage and provision. So in terms of strategies, if you're not familiar with them, Blue-Green is essentially a basic strategy where you have an old version of the application, version one, it's the blue version. And then I'm coming along and a developer's made a code change, I want to deploy the new version, and it's the green version. My users are still hitting the blue version, but I've got the green version deployed and I can actually go in and test it independently and not impact any user traffic and make sure that it's fit for purpose before I switch traffic over to the new version. And when the new version is running after a certain period of time and I'm satisfied that, you know, that new version is holding up, it works great, I can scale down the old version and get rid of it. Canary is really kind of an advanced version of the blue-green strategy where, similar to the old proverb, the canary in the coal mine, which is always a bit ghoulish, but essentially where miners would take the canary down in the mine, and if the canary died, they knew they had to boot it back out of the mine because the air was bad. The idea here really is that you can deploy a small percentage of users onto the new version of the application and get live feedback about whether that new version is working out, and if it's not, roll it back and replace it with the old version. So in this canary example here, we got the old version, which is the blue version. We deploy a new version. We route 10% of the user traffic to that green version, and we wait a while. We'll pause for a bit. And then the next step will essentially increase that routing to 33%. Things still holding up. Things still look good. We'll then shuffle the traffic to 100%, and similar to the blue's green, we get rid of the old version, the blue one, right? Now we're running the new one. So Rollouts will handle all of these strategies for you, and it'll provide the testing that you need to do between moving from the new and the old version. This is where analysis templates come into play. So an analysis template, you can really think of it as a way to integrate with a variety of different metrics providers. You could also run jobs in it. And the idea behind it really is to get the data and make determinations about whether the new version is fit for purpose and is meeting the roles, meeting the expectations of what you want to do with that new version that's working correctly. So it can integrate with things like Prometheus, for example. It can integrate with web URLs to pull those metrics down. And then you can write a bit of JSON to figure out kind of whether or not it passed. So that analysis can also define the failure conditions. So you can say, you know, I'm going to measure this, like, say, 5 times. And as long as there's not more than one failure, like one failure is okay, but two, nope, that's no good. I'm going to stop that, and we're going to roll back to the old version. You can control that because, again, every application is going to have different characteristics of how that's going to work. With the Canary, an analysis can be run in a variety of different ways. You can run it as a background, which is essentially it's running in parallel with the deployment. You can also run it as an inline step where the Canary will actually pause, do the analysis, make sure things are good to go before continuing on with the progression of moving the weight of the traffic. And with Blue-Green, the analysis can be run pre or post-promotion. So pre is useful in the sense that I want to make sure the new version is good to go. Post is useful in that, okay, I've got the new version rolled out, users are hitting it, but I still want to look at some metrics to make sure that users are not having unexpected issues with it. The other neat thing is that a job can be run as part of the analysis. In the workshop, you'll see that we're going to run an open source utility called Siege to drive load in order to generate the metrics that we need to make sure that the application is working successfully. So that's a very, 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 very quick overview of Rollouts. Like I said, I don't want to spend a ton of time on it because the value in the workshop is really hands-on keyboard, not listening to me talk. As much as my wife might disagree. No, she wouldn't disagree. She'd be fully aligned with that. So the way the workshop is going to work is you will get some URLs. The left side of the room will get one cluster. The right side of the room will get a different cluster. And you will register with your email address and your workshop password that I'll give you as well. And the idea here is you don't have to use your real email if you don't want to. We're not going to contact you or anything. But do use an email you remember, because if you lose the registration page and you need to get that information back, if you don't put in the same thing, you'll get registered as a new user, right? And you'll be starting at square one. So do use an email address that you know about. Once you register, you will get this screen that you see here on the right side. This will give you the workshop lab guide with the instructions that you need to do the workshop. The second link is the console URL for the OpenShift cluster that you're going to need to log into. And then you'll get a user login with your user name. It'll be like user 1, user 2, user 3, and then the password, which will be OpenShift. So once you do that, and I'm just going to go through the process. Like I said, here's the lab guide. I'll just go ahead and click on it. So you can see here all the content that you'll be going through. You can just click on the different things. Now, when you do things in the lab guide, let me just scroll down, you will see that it represents things that you need to input using this kind of orangey yellowish box, and there's a copy icon here. You just copy that text out and you can paste it into the terminal that I'll show you in a second and drive the workshop that way. When you go to log into the OpenShift cluster, let me do this here. I never thought holding a mic and talking at the same time would be difficult. And I should have provisioned. Essentially, what you're going to do is the workshop walks you through this, but you're going to provision a terminal. Sorry. Now I understand what happened. One second. I was logged in as the cluster admin, just checking that everything's working. User one. Type password in, open shift. Okay, so once you get in, you click this icon up here. And again, the workshop walks you through all this. It will give you a web terminal in the OpenShift cluster right here. And then you can start running commands and copying those commands from the workshop into this. Now, if you're running something like Chrome, it doesn't sometimes like hotkeys, like Control-C, for example, to copy. What you're going to need to do to paste is Control-Shift-V. And what you're going to need to do to copy is probably just use the menu. Highlight what you want. And then just use the copy menu here if you need to copy things out. If you have any problems, just let us know. We're more than happy to spend more time on logistics and walk you through it. So that's a very quick overview of what you're going to be doing for the workshop. Before I get you started, any questions on this so far? All clear? What? No, there won't be any SSHing. This is all just done through that terminal and using essentially kubectl or the OC command in our OpenShift case. Was there another question over there? Okay, so let's get you started. Let me go back to slideshow. All right, so here is the URL for the workshop. So it will be at demo.redhat.com/workshop and then slash some characters. Depending on the side of the room that you're sitting on, you will either get the left side, which will be PKE VWC that you'll replace the XXXS with, or if you're on the right side of the room, 9MHD3X, very friendly URLs, right? Anyways, those are pretty straightforward to type. And then the password that you need to register for the workshop is RH-Rollouts. Hopefully that's visible to everybody. If you have trouble seeing it, you're more than welcome to step up with your phone and just snap a picture with the camera. And otherwise, I'll let you get going. No. Yeah, like I said, we're not using your emails or anything. This is all done with a separate system. So, but if you're uncomfortable and you don't want to put your email in, feel free not to. Just put in something that you remember as an email address, right? Batman@dc.com, for example, works. Unless Johnny's taken that already. Let me just try it here. Oops, sorry. By the way, if you're running like an internal firewall from a, if your company or whatever, you may need to disable it. Control V. Sorry, where's my slides? Right there. So, I mean, I just went to this screen here. You're not getting it? Johnny, could you just have a look at his, maybe? Is everybody else getting that screen all right? Or okay, so at least we know it's working for some people. Okay, thank you. Hang on.
really? Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
No, Andrew forever. Mm-hmm. Yeah, he's
And you're doing right now, you're doing the jobs also on applications. Mm-hmm. It's also you're watching the
app. Yeah, it's cool. I was helping out on my person. She's like, hey, do you want to do this? Yeah, yeah,
yeah.
Yeah, it's good. It's good. She's like high energy, and you know, I feed off her energy. I'm high energy too, so I start looking for her.
Yeah,
she's funny. But no, it's a lot of fun. I love doing it. So.
That's so cool.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What's that? Yeah, so fortunately on the GitHub side, Tori does everything. Like, I literally just show up and, like, I try and schedule stuff and try and get everything done. But, like, all the actual work she does. So that's really cool. With Andrew, though, yeah, it's like, trying to find people and make sure that they're good to go. Find, you know, find topics and stuff like that. So it is.
And do you guys
do what?
Rehearse
to never rehearse. No, it's all that. Neither one of us. Like, get off the ones. Yeah. Yeah, it's like what you see is it's what you get. Yeah. And even when we have guests coming on and we're talking to them, don't put too much thought into it. Like, be natural, right? Come on, talk about the things that you want to talk about. Don't go learn something that you come up here and talk about. Come up here and talk about what you know. And then that way, it's you just chill. You know, and so it's literally just nerds talking at that point. You know, that's it. And so people, they listen, most of the time they listen.
Yeah.
And you do really well.
Yeah. I had a ton of contacts in the job. I was so glad.
From my picture, they're fantastic. And then that's probably one of my favorite episodes because I can't remember his name.
Now we're talking about
yeah.
He's here.
Is
he? I saw him. Okay.
I ran into him in Germany. I was out there for like a project and I was like, oh shit.
Just doing a check-in to make sure nobody's having any problems. Walked around, seems like everybody's fine, but sometimes you get people that are shy. So if you have a problem, feel free to stick up your hand. Okay. The other thing, too, as you're going through it, if you have questions about rollouts, how they work, you know, how they fit into what you're doing already, by all means, feel free to stick a hand up, and one of us are more than happy to talk to you about it. Thanks very much. Thank you.
Zephyr version. So like, this is just a plug that option to we did a Prowl, and the Prowl is like a Kubernetes CI, and it's like it's what Hypershift is using like to do all their CI testing. So one of the developers for Prowl came on, and last Thursday, and she's also a one of the people for the Kubernetes release. So she's like in charge of a certain section within the Kubernetes release cycle. So she's like, this is awesome. But she did good. No, it's never ending. No, I appreciate it. Thank you very much, Sage. Yeah. I know Andrew loves doing it. I love doing it. So it's a lot of fun.
This is kind of like the same. Choose the time to start to do it. It's usually, well, for here it is, yeah. So I'm calling people that schedule things on it. But for customers, how can we do this workshop? How do we do this workshop?
Hey, just want to do a quick check to see where people are. Can you put up your hand if you've done module one? How about module two? Module three? Whoa, some keen folks here. Module four? Okay. All right, thanks very much.
works, we can roll that out to everybody.
I
Hey folks, just a time check to let you know that there's 34 minutes left in the workshop. I'm only mentioning it because there'll be a hard stop because there's going to be some closing remarks session that are going to be held in here, so we'll all get kicked out and go away. So just to let you know, you got 34 minutes left in this room in this workshop. We'll see where everybody is at the end of that 30 minutes and maybe leave the clusters up for, you know, another half an hour if you need it to finish it off, if you want to after. And we'll do a little poll to see where people are and what they want to do. So thanks very much.
There'll be a conclusion. Yeah, so the 30-minute mark, or yeah. We'll do the quickie conclusion, I'll do the poll. How many people have finished? How many people still want me to leave the clusters up for the first one, so they can finish it?
Yeah.
I don't want to do it too much longer. I don't have 100 users, so it's not cheap. Does he make the travel report?
Yeah.
I don't. Eric's never told me to write a travel report. So.
Yeah, we'll put on the travel report.
Yeah.
I'm just joking with you, obviously.
Oh, I know. What about this? What about that?
Why are you so focused?
Leave me alone.
And what's good or not? I don't know what's good. I mean, what?
That makes everything better, right? So,
like, what about the conclusion? What about the intro to the moment?
So we basically, if there's been a thing that's been delivered, right, like medical diagnosis, that's one of our work, they did it for the beginning, and so we took it, and there's a bunch of answers. Let's go. Sure. Yeah, you got you. They wrote a bunch of answers, dissected it, and put it in GitOps, and that's pretty much what we did. team and now, so now we're actually starting to do this stuff. And I was talking to some guys who were at NLM, National Library of Medicine. They had a building we would come, kind of a tough mentality. So we're going to build this cluster for mass developers. So show them how to load it. And I was like, well, how many continuous applications do you have? And they're like, none. And I said, how many security developers do you have that know how to use containers or develop on containers?
Yeah,
I'm pretty sure.
something like that. But so, and the people. And I've heard in Quebec it's the same. No, it, that wasn't Chris. But I've heard the Quebec folks.
Hey folks, there's 5 minutes left here, so I just want to do a quick wrap up for the folks that are left here. I hope everybody enjoyed the workshop, and just curious, did people are still here? Are you still working on it? Did you get to the final module? Or okay, we're good. All right, okay, close enough for government work. All right, that's all good. So in this workshop, you learned how rollouts work and the capabilities that it brings versus a standard deployment in terms of its advanced strategies like Blue-Green and Canary, as well the analysis template and the ability to do testing and do things like load testing as well to drive those metrics in order to determine whether that new version is good to go or you need to do a rollback. These are all things that I think, like I said, really simplify the usage of those advanced deployment strategies versus, you know, trying to hand bomb a bunch of automation and to do it yourself with deployments. So I would encourage you to check out the Rollouts community. It's a well-documented project, so you can go through the documentation. There is a Slack channel on the CNCF Slack forums, Argo Rollouts. You can join that if you have questions about it or you want to ask some more in-depth architecture stuff. It's a great place to go as well. And you're also welcome to reach out to any of the Red Hatters, myself, Johnny, Valentina, if you have questions about rollouts as well, and be happy to have a conversation. So thanks very much, everybody, for attending. You still got 3 minutes here, but at that point, they're going to shut down and do the closing remarks. So thanks very much, and have a good rest of the con. Thank you.